What's going on, guys? Your boy TG, and today we're going to be talking about the top five youngest NHL players to keep an eye on for the 2022-2023 season. So up first, I got Shane Wright of the Seattle Kraken, and I say Shane Wright because he was pretty upset that he didn't go first overall in the NHL draft, and I just feel like coming into the 2022-2023 season, he's going to come out strong. He's going to prove the Canadians that he should have been drafted first overall. So he's going to have a good season and possibly might win the Calder Trophy. So Shane Wright is somebody to keep an eye on. He gives a little give and goes. His skating is excellent, and his position to obtain the extended offensive zone time. The early passes that he makes really pops. Where most players try and beat the defender, he simply passes to the open teammate and lets them manage the space. And he's probably the best runaway manufacturer I ever seen at this level. So I read that off of a website. So I think Shane Wright possibly might win the Calder Trophy this year because good, talented player. And he's going to have a good, one of the best seasons in his career. If he does this good in the season, he might be an all-star player for the 2023 NHL All-Star Game that will be in Florida. So he should come out strong in 2022-2023 season. And next up on my list, I got Trevor Zegras of the Anaheim Ducks. And I say Trevor Zegras because based on the excellent season he had last year, he's going to carry that momentum into the 2022-2023 season. And he should have won a Calder Trophy this year, but Moritz Seider took the Calder Trophy home for Best Rookie of the Year. So I feel like Trevor Zegras is going to be a Hall of Famer in the future. And this kid has a lot of momentum going forward for the next few seasons. He's going to give it his all. So every season that Trevor Zegras plays, he's going to give it his all. He's going to have a tremendous impact. And plus, he might pull off a few more Michigan moves in the 2022-2023 season. So stay forward to that. So he's just somebody to keep an eye on for this upcoming season. Really skilled, really talented. This kid has it all in him. And I look forward to seeing some more highlights of him and some more plays of him in the near future. Let's moving on to Cale Makar of the Colorado Avalanche. And as you guys can see, I got on Colorado Avalanche Stanley Cup gear. So I got on the, this is actually a long sleeve shirt, but I just folded the sleeves back. So I got on the Avalanche Stanley Cup champion shirt. And I say Cale Makar is somebody to keep an eye on because let's look back at the season that he had. Winning the Norris Trophy for Best Defenseman, winning the Conn Smythe Trophy for MVP in the playoffs, and most of all, winning the Stanley Cup. I say that Cale Makar is the Connor McDavid of defense, and I say that because he's basically just like Connor McDavid. He can make a few plays. I think he might be sort of a playmaker and could be a offensive defenseman instead of a defensive defenseman. I describe him as an offensive defenseman because he does like to make a lot of plays. Really skilled. And plus, like I said, he's the Connor McDavid defense. So, and if Cale Makar has a good season this year, he could possibly take home the Norris again. And he could be in the All-Star game. I think he was in the All-Star game in Las Vegas. I think he was an All-Star. So, if he keeps this up going to the 2022-2023 season and moving forward, he's going to be a Hall of Famer too. So, that's somebody to keep an eye on. going into the 2022-2023 season. And Cale Makar, he's one of my favorite players from the Colorado Avalanche. I do have a shirt of him somewhere. I do have a shirt of him, but I didn't put it on. I should have put it on, but I just got on the Avalanche Stanley Cup shirt. And number fourth, we got Juraj Slafkovský. You guys probably know who I'm talking about. He got drafted number one overall to the Montreal Canadiens. And yes, Shane Wright was upset. Sorry, guys, I have braces. Can't really understand what I'm saying. But Shane Wright was upset that he didn't go number one overall to the Montreal Canadiens. I mean, everybody thought he was going to go number one overall, but he didn't. And fun fact, while he was going up on stage, he gave a stare down to the Montreal Canadiens table when he got drafted by the Seattle Kraken in the NHL draft. And I say Slafkovský is somebody to keep an eye on because he's a big man, and he's going to be playing with Kirby Dach and Cole Caulfield. I like to see Martin St. Louis put them on the line together, see how they do, mostly for Slafkovský and Dach, because those are going to be the two big men on the team. And he's 6'4", 229 pounds. So, yep, he's a big man. And Slafkovský brings a lot more to the table than just brute force. What makes him a unique prospect is how he turns those extended possessions sequences into legitimate scoring chances. Sometimes it's a drive to the net for a chance of his own. Other times he'll handle his way into a passing opportunity and send the puck to his linemate to finish the job. So if I was NHL Hall of Famer and current Montreal Canadiens coach Martin St. Louis, I would put Slafkovský and Dach on the same line together. I'll probably add Caulfield just to spice things up. So, but I really want to watch Slafkovský and Dach play together on the same line. So Slafkovský is somebody to keep an eye on playing for the Montreal Canadiens. Got drafted first overall. So he's somebody to keep an eye on for this season. He probably might have a solid good season. Would I say call the trophy favorite? Maybe. Maybe call the trophy favorite. But we just have to see for the 2022-2023 season. And last but not least, I got Logan Cooley of the Arizona Coyotes. So he got drafted third overall to the Coyotes, Pittsburgh native, 5'10", 181 pounds. So this kid is going to give it his all this year. And he's at the bottom of my list because I won't expect that much from him. But I do like to see somebody like Logan Cooley have a solid good season. So he might have a solid good season. I wouldn't say he's called a trophy favorite, but I really don't know. Just have to see for the 2022-2023 season. But this kid should have, all in all, kind of a good season or not. So the way he seamlessly blends past receptions at speed into his first move with breaking stride is almost unfair. Whether it's catching a difficult pass on the backhand, forehand, or inside a crossover, Cooley's making it happen. I don't expect that much from Logan Cooley, but I do expect solid season. I would say he scores 20 goals. Like I said, I really don't expect that much from him. He probably won't score a lot, but let's just start with 20. 20 goals, probably 45 assists for 65 points to end the season. I might be wrong. That's just a prediction. Like I said, I really don't expect that a lot from him. He should have a solid good season overall. And yeah, just somebody to keep your eye on, keep an eye on. So this is my list right here, guys. Shane Wright at number one. I like to see a lot from Shane Wright. I'm trying to get the marker off. So Shane Wright at number one. Trevor Zegras at number two. Kale McCarr at number three. Juraj Slavkovský at number four. And Logan Cooley at number five. So can't wait for this season. I'm really going to be keeping an eye on Shane Wright just to see how he does. With the Seattle Kraken, he probably might prove the Montreal Canadiens wrong. And I'd see him probably get a hat trick against the Canadiens. So when these two teams play, of course you guys know Shane Wright's on the Seattle Kraken. And when they play against the Montreal Canadiens, I dropped it. Okay, I'll pick it up later. But I like to see Shane Wright get a hat trick against the Montreal Canadiens. Obviously, that would be unreal to score a hat trick against the team that you thought you were going to go to, team that you think you should have gone to. So, yeah. But that's going to do it for me, guys. If you enjoyed this video, hit it with a like. Hit it with a subscribe. If you guys have any comments, drop them down in the comments section. Share this video if you will. And that's going to do it for me, guys. And I'll see you guys next time.